Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Let's Design Cities Skylines. My name is Strict Toaster, and we are back at Cedar Valley, where there's quite a bit that needs to be done, as usual. So we're going to get started right away, and before I do anything else, we need to take care of some issues that I was just noticing off camera, which is, which are, because there are more than one. We have, this buildings need some water, and this buildings need some power. And I also noticed that we're running short on garbage collection and things. So we're going to take care of that in this episode right away. But later on, we're going to be focusing our attention on this part of the map, where we're going to actually start working on our rail yard. We're probably going to get rid of this because it's not too pretty. I'm not sure I like it. But we're going to have several train tracks lined up over in this area. And hopefully we can get some rare, very nice and very industrial-like, environment. And we have a ton of props. I downloaded so many. Look. I mean, I'm not going to show you in detail. We're going to cover those in a few minutes, but we have quite a bit of material to work with. So let me just start by fixing the power issue here. And I also downloaded this mod, which is the underground power cables. So I'm going to get rid of this high tension lines or the power lines. And what this mod does is, allows you to freely plop this little substations. And you can actually plop them this way. Maybe for symmetry's sake, we'll just have it there. And maybe, hopefully, we can move this one just slightly over one tile. There we go. Fantastic. And now we have a power line with no cables. Isn't that beautiful? Look at how tiny and pretty this is. Then we can just go first person view. There we go. It's kind of interesting. So much detail there. In any case, another thing that we need to do is fix the water problem here. It's a quick fix. Just extend the water mains just over there. Let's just clear this, and just for the sake of having everything be pretty, I guess not. Never mind. And let's see what else. Some warning here. Too few services. Yeah, we're going to take care of that soon enough. But our trash landfills are basically full, so yeah, let's take a look at that. We're going to need some incinerators. Don't we have one? What's the capacity on this? Let's take a look at garbage. Oh, we're almost operating the limit here, so we might need another one. Let's do a smaller one somewhere here. Can we do that? Let's see. Is there a better spot for something like this? Let's just put it here for now. So it's almost like a smaller version of this one. They're even the same logo, right? Incinitech. Ooh, I like that. Let's take a look at this. Incinitech, there we go. All right, so hopefully our incineration capacity has increased just slightly. Hopefully that will fix itself soon. These buildings still don't have any power, but they should be connected. Oh, one more issue. This turbine might not be enough, so I'm going to plop another one. I don't love the location of these. This is just temporary until we get this area connected to this, because basically this massive coal power plant that we have here can pretty much provide power for our current city and a little bit more. So the problem is that since this is not connected to this, and I don't want to lay down power lines just yet, we're just going to have some cute power lines. Sorry, some cute turbines is what I mean. We're also going to connect this over here because maybe they can solve this traffic backup a little bit. And I would just get started right away with our rail project. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have several lines that will go parallel to each other, and it's going to be a lot of fun. We're actually going to plop some of these train cars that I bought, that I downloaded from the Steam Workshop. I actually got this idea from Reddit. I'm gonna try to, if I remember correctly, I'll post a link in the description of this video. If not, you can check out my Twitter, twitter.com/strictoaster, because I tweeted this with a cute screenshot of a rail yard in the middle of the forest, and that's where I got the idea from. So yeah, make sure to check that out. And it's gonna be a lot of fun. So we're gonna get rid of this fence for now. Eventually we're gonna bring it back, most likely. Most of these tracks are different types. So we have the abandoned type that should have some foliage going around that I do have installed, which I think it's the Gula. Where's the Gula? I guess it doesn't, oh, this one. It's kind of like, should have this, this thing's just plopped all over. Let me go back to the speed to one. For some reason, it's not doing it. But we do have one of the train tracks that I actually really like is, I think it's this one, which is, no, not that one. It's a different kind of, prop that also I don't have. This one, which is concrete, and it actually blends in with the sidewalks. So I'm really looking forward to using this. But for the time being, I'm just gonna use the regular one, which I'm guessing it's train tracks, this one. This is the default one. As you can see, it has a bit of a gravel around it, which is also pretty nice, which I'm thinking of using as well. And we're gonna start by plopping down some of these train stations. So, in order to put these to good use, I think I'm going to leave that space over there. And we might have to bring... Actually, you know what? I'm not sure I wanted this, because in the parks menu, I also have other ones that are slightly bigger. Like this one, for example. I kind of want to use this one. Or not just or, but maybe and... this one as well, which is kind of like a construction area. So hopefully I'm going to start using this as a reference. And let's go back to, let's use the concrete tracks, which I think are the first one. Concrete, no cable. Oh, these are no cables. I guess I'm okay with that. Yeah, that should be fine. Wait, abandon, concrete train. Let's see how they look actually stuck to each other. I think I want one of each, to be honest. So let's go for that. I clicked on the wrong menu, of course. We're gonna have this. There's gonna be so many railroad crossings here, so we might have to do something about that, meaning maybe we can have an overpass or, I don't know, some sort of, you know what? This, yeah. So we need to plan this a little bit ahead, because I don't want the stations to be sitting against this avenue. And potentially I want to have this avenue be an overpass. So we might as well start with the overpass, and based on that, we can figure things out, because that's what we're going to do. So page up, position the camera properly. I want to go up to 15 meters, should be okay. Maybe up to there. Let's go back to this view right here. 15 meters up to there. And oh no, I'm off by one little square. You know what? Let's just continue this way. Go up. 15, oh, it wants to snap. I don't want it to snap. It's tricky. Actually, yeah, let's try that again. I'm kind of eyeballing it, which is not the best thing ever. Yeah, it's off. I feel like the angle is just tricking me into believing that it's a line. When it's not. Okay, so this one's a line, pretty sure. Let's go back to 15, connect back there. And there we go. We have a nice overpass that is totally not connected. So let's actually fix that real quick. There we go. So now that is connected. I think this is tall enough for trains. Let's make sure that that is the case. Let's bring that to 0 meters. This is absolutely perfect. All right. So we have one of our overpasses. Do we want to do it on this side too? Maybe not. Maybe not. And the reason why is because I want to have some of these roads right here. So seems like a good idea over here. I don't think I can get that road to go underneath that overpass, nor do I know if I want to do that. So let's see, just for a second. Is this the limit? No, this is not the limit. Okay, so this is as close as the pillar as it would go, which is okay. And if I go like this, which is the other road, that means I can fit here maybe 2 train tracks, which it's probably very little. Actually, I can fit 3. Quite possibly, if the snap tool helps me. I had it for a second. Come on, do it. There we go. Which looks cool, kind of like it. Now, what I need is one of these tracks to sort of branch out and let me, wait a minute, can I actually, this might be totally not pretty, but hopefully it might help us. Let's go 15 meters right over here and maybe we can have a nice, beautiful intersection here. No, you want to snap over there, which is not terrible, but also not very pretty. It's definitely industrial, so I'm liking that. But you know what? I'm going to get rid of this road right here. Actually, I'm going to get rid of both roads and have enough, a little bit more room to play around with the tracks. I'm going to clear this as well, just for the time being. And let's bring, this is going to be a long episode. I'm already kind of feeling that it's going to take quite some time. Can I really not fit that? Hold on one second. This brings up some possibilities. Okay, so let's go back to the transport menu. See if we can get these train stations. I want to mirror this on the other side, potentially. If I can, so we need to get rid of this. Let's grab the normal tracks, which are the last ones, I think. Just because they match this prop that I just plopped, pretty much. And so we have that. Let's extend this over to the other side. There we go. So far, so good. So let's grab another street. And so we had a 5-tile gap from here, so I love it when it does that. Not really. Let's try that again. Actually, it doesn't really matter because all I want to know is if I can fit another one of these. Yeah, I can't. I'm going to need one more tile. That's okay. That is okay. I have plenty of room to work with. So I'm not bothered by this not being symmetrical. And the fact that I say with that tone, it means that I'm totally bothered by that. But it's not too bad. Actually, like, that looks pretty nice, if I do say so myself. So, let's see. Yeah. I'm sticking with this. So, okay, cool. A few things. One thing that we need to do is maybe stretch these lines, these train tracks. So, okay, many things. let me get my ideas straight. So we want one of these train tracks to actually go through the city. In fact, maybe want the main line to sort of branch out on one side and then go into the rail yard that could potentially end somewhere here. and some dead ends over here, as well as a line that will basically loop around and have a few suburban stations as well as a metropolitan station somewhere here, and then potentially connect it to the rest of the city. Let's continue with this rail yard first, because I do have some control over that. So right here, we're just gonna merge the two train tracks like so. That's pretty pretty. I want a bit of a, hang on, can we get this? I'm gonna need some guidance here. So let's grab a piece of road like so. And let's see if I can, I cannot align this here, can't I? There's plenty of room. Oh, there's not room for the railroad crossing, but there is for just a train track. So maybe we can get that. Now, do I want this to be a dead end, or do I think dead end here it should be okay? So let's just bring it over here. In fact, let's use the other one that doesn't have the power, the catenaries. So abandoned. This one actually looks quite nice. Also, it's abandoned, so that helps. Oh, it's like totally abandoned. This is going to be a pretty active rail yard. I'm guessing abandoned might not be the best option for this part, but let me get the concrete one, which I think is this one. Let's just get it somewhere there. There we go. So that's pretty cool. In fact, if we go with floating and overlap, actually, I'm not sure which of the two buttons actually do what I want, but I do know that that combination gets what I want done. So what I want to do is maybe try to squeeze in this concrete path over here without avoiding to like break everything if possible. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Snapped at the last second. Which is okay. I mean, it doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. This just has to be... I wish it wouldn't snap right at the last minute. Okay, so I like that better. So we have that. This is actually pretty cool. I'm not sure about this, but maybe we can... Oh. Can do this. Fantastic. All right, so now we have a bit of a continuous cement here. I like it. There's definitely some character going on. You know what, let's just get another of these gravel paths right here in between. There we go. So now we're filling the gaps. This is looking so much nicer than I expected it. So I want this line to connect to this one, and this one do this one. And it's all gonna be fine and dandy. So let's I wonder how these two will connect, because they're like different, they have different textures and things. So let's grab the concrete one, which I think is this one. Oh, that's not too bad. I am okay with that. Let's just bring this over here. It's a good spot to end it. And this one over there. Not too shabby. And let's just, should we do some sort of weird thing like this? I could have sworn that it's actually not bad. Okay, I'm sticking with that. I like that. So this is just to give you a quick idea of our achieving, or trying to achieve here. This is what we're going to do. We're going to have, let's see, let's just grab a dark tanker. So we're going to plop them one by one like this. These are can be plopped pretty much anywhere as long as you have the overlap feature on. So we're gonna have a big, I'm not getting the spacing perfectly, but it should be okay. So we have, it's almost like decorating a park, but just made out of train tracks. That's pretty cool. So this is gonna be tricky because I can't see a thing. There we go. Fantastic. Let's get the other one over here. And so that's one. That actually looks quite epic. This is so epic. I love it. Okay, so wait, we're gonna have another one right next to it. This is just gonna be crazy. This is going to be crazy. Let's do something that doesn't have a whole lot of color. I don't want this to be like super shiny. Let's get, come on, you can totally do this. This is kind of not centered. I thought that this was just overlapping everything, but I guess it doesn't really overlap other. I guess if we move these just slightly over, I don't really want to do this, but let's just say that we move that over there just a tiny bit. And now we can get the other one there. So these two are sort of a line now. But you know what? For the time being, maybe you only need one here. Now we know how to probably do it, but maybe we only need one. This one is definitely not a line now to the rest of the formation. So I'm going to move it over there because the shadow is kind of in the middle. There we go. And maybe, does this need a locomotive? Maybe it does. Maybe it does. So this is a cargo locomotive. Let's put it there. Nice. I love this. This is so epic. Okay. I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's continue the main layout of the tracks. Just wanted to show you that because when I saw the first time this dude made it, I'm like, yes, I'm totally doing that for sure. So I guess it's happening. It is happening. So let's get some more of these. Can I actually connect this right here? Yeah, I'm okay with that. This will have to maybe be turned into one of these overpasses, to be honest, because there's going to be so much traffic, and then we're going to have internal streets that will connect to the actual rail yard. So yeah, let's actually replicate the same bridge design so we don't let's actually bring it back to pillars and collide. There we go. So we want to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Unfortunately, we're going to need to take care of this before doing anything else, and maybe that as well. Let's get that out of the way. 15. Actually, let's make sure that, oh, didn't mean to hit escape. I think it's this one. Yeah, this is totally the one. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like so. Connect the two. All right, so now we have our space. Question is, the train tracks will totally fit there. And in fact, this power line in the middle is just gonna stay in the middle. We might not even have to move it. Let's take a look. You see? It totally stays there. So, what do we wanna do here? I think I wanna keep, oh no, we have pillars here. Wait. Check this out, overlap. I love this feature so much. Oh, it wants to snap. There we go. I mean, it doesn't really, it's not in the way. It's okay, it's just right there, even though, oh, we haven't even tried here on this side. I bet it's the same issue. But we'll take care of it. We will take care of it. In fact, so there's a type of train station that I wanted to plop. Let's actually take a look at that real quick. It's under the parks menu, which is a bit of a construction site. I don't want to put it right next to the place. Hang on. How does this look? This doesn't seem like it's a good fit here. What about maybe just randomly? Oh, hang on. Let's turn it on collide again, just to make sure that we have what we need. How does that look? Not what I wanted. I kind of want to plop this in a spot where, so I guess these two dead end streets, dead end tracks actually look quite okay. Let's bring back to overlap. And maybe we can get this down like this. Continue three tracks. Like so, and ring this here. So that's looking much, much nicer, I gotta say. I'm okay that these are dead ends, sort of. In fact, let's see if I can get squeeze in like a straight line there. I mean, honestly, we can even fit some trains underneath here. The clearance is fine. It's just this right here might not work. Or does it? It's a bit too tight. In fact, maybe this one could benefit from not having the cables up. So not only is not the... I wish they had different icons. So not abandoned, concrete, one way. I think this is the one. There we go. And in fact, you know what? We can just simply bring this back here. All right, so we can have a few of these trains just to park over here. Let's do that just to mix it up a bit. I do like this tanker trains, but let's do something different because I feel like this is a bit of a construction area. So no zoning, collide, overlap, fantastic. Floating, oh, you really don't want me to do it over there. That's fine. That's totally fine. Doesn't have to be a whole train. Just maybe a few, just, you know, cars here and there. For some reason, it really lags my computer when I turn the camera. There we go. How does that look? That looks pretty cool. Do like it. That's nice. See if we can fit another row of cars right next to it. Maybe in this case we can have something a little bit more colorful. Oh, it totally allows me to do that. So this is kind of, you know, dead end storage for cars. This one is almost not. This is, yeah. We're not gonna have that one there. But potentially we can continue putting them down if I can get the camera to be properly aligned. I mean, I'm not sure really what's going on there, but we do have some cool trains in there. Maybe get rid of this and add, where are the cargo things that I just plopped? This one. It's right on the limit. We can always extend this just by a pixel. So let's go ahead and do that, which was no cable, this one. Just a tiny bit, there we go. I'm actually not opposed to that. We kind of have a rail yard going. Isn't that exciting? Pretty excited. Let's, we have this road here. Haven't thought of that. I guess this road will sort of turn around and connect to this. So I guess it's not that big of a deal. Not that though. Just straight and here. In fact, Oh, I wish that it wouldn't do that. Hang on. You can have something like that. I'd rather actually have a perfect curve here, so let's just go like this and like that. All right. That about does it for me. And let's see, what do I do here? So I guess we need some sort of entrance into this part. So let's just get that going like so. And what about here? Can we go straight? Does it even... here there's definitely not enough clearance for this. So we're not going to do it. Even though we have the power of this overlap tool allowing us to construct wherever we want, it's really not great. Actually, what about something like this? I'm not opposed to having a diagonal here. Maybe a straight line. That is disgusting. So no. Nope. Definitely not. But we can have it just a dead end here, and we can put down some props. In fact, let's just go ahead and do that real quick. We can have let's back to collide. Oh, because we didn't have Sony here, so we need to do this again, unfortunately. Is that what it is? Yeah, there we go. Okay, so now we can zone stuff over there. And let's just plop a few of these things. So this is a car repair shop, but nothing. It's just an industrial look for the most part. Let's see, what else do we have? We have a ton of things. Industrial park. It's just like, this is like industrial garbage, basically. Can we fit this somewhere here nice? I want to get rid of this. So let's get rid of all this, because this is not... It's not as pretty as the new Railyard track, so... We're going to clear all of this. There we go. Leave no traces of this. I do want to have some sort of a station here. If possible, just clear all this. Fantastic. I'm going to move this now to about here, just for the time being, because maybe we can fit in a some train tracks over here. I think that will be nice. So let's take a look at what we can plop first. Oh, we have so many of these. This can be plopped pretty much everywhere you want, so, might give this a shot somewhere. How does that look? Not too bad. Don't necessarily think it fits. What if we do overlap? Ooh, that opens so many possibilities, to be honest. I mean, it kind of integrates with our current rail yard. So, might leave that there. And let's just get some more cement, if possible. This is where they pretty much throw all their crap that they don't want. Not too bad. And we're gonna add some more things in here. For the most part, I'm thinking of adding some plants and like dead bushes or something like that. I don't know, just make it very industrial and almost unappealing, but it's gonna be so appealing because it's actually made for us. So yeah, this is actually looking fantastic. I never thought we could actually build something like this. So wow, I'm really happy with this, and this is just the beginning. We're not even close to being done with this, by the way. Just so you know, Let's continue the train construction. So here we want to merge that one over there. And I think eventually this is going to be merged to this. We're gonna kill this, and that's gonna be our main track. However, this doesn't look great, so I wanna try to see if I can get it positioned better. It seems like a really tight curve, to be absolutely honest with you, but maybe, wait, let's see if we can, I'm gonna kill this just for the time being, because maybe I want to stretch that one instead, just because it's closer to the to this track over here. So there we go. Let's just complete it with the gravel really quickly. There we go. I love this completing gaps. It works so well. I do. The only thing that I'm sort of afraid is that if I disable one of these mods, this save game is completely going to crash. So, but I guess that's what it is. It is what it is. So let me get this track over here. Get this connected like that. And like so. And that's the beginning of our major rail yard. We just need to complete the gaps a little bit here. Wonder how this is going to look if I just add cement instead of gravel. Not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. There we go. I mean, this definitely has to be cement now. There's really no other way around it. Can we do both cement and this is abandoned. I think this is it. This is just abandoned. Okay, so I think it's this one. No cables and there we go. That actually looks great, even though the cables are kind of fading out, which I'm not crazy about, but it works. It works. Also, we have that problem over there. We can fix that later, actually. It's not. I'm not too worried about that. Let's see if we can fix some of these issues here, but just throwing more. No, we can always put down plants there, so not too worried about that. Let's put another formation of fancy wagons. So we're gonna do containers in this case. Let me just rotate the train cars just a little bit. So we're gonna leave, they're not gonna be perfectly centered just because we won't be able to plop others right next to them. Let's actually move these a little bit over to the side, just like so, and I think that way we have enough space to put down a road right next to these. Oh man, so close yet so far away. So what I want is actually mix this up with the colors a little bit so that it looks a little bit more random. And that actually looks quite nice, just like that. And this way we can potentially fit the red locomotive too. There we go. So that's actually pretty nice. I'm actually liking this layout so far. This one also looks quite decent. And we're gonna start adding a few more of these formations, just spark here and there, especially on these dead end tracks, because They actually look quite beautiful. But I think this has been a long episode, so I'm gonna make a quick cut here and wrap this one up. So if you enjoyed, please do leave it a rating. That's very much appreciated. And also, please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. In the next episode, I'm probably gonna be just to change gears a little bit, even though we already kind of have this going. I'm gonna try to see if I can fix this off camera, or we can just get the freeway position in between the city and the industrial area, and maybe continuing the layout of the railroad tracks, just to, you know, spread out in different directions so that we can actually have more stations and traffic flowing through here. So I really hope you enjoyed, and I hope to see you in the next one.